Возьму две карты, правильно?
Разумеешь три карты?
When Igor Bancer isn't spending time with his kids, he's a punk. Bancer is the front man for Mr. X, where he's become known for bad-mouthing the government at his shows and online. Last year, he was arrested for public indecency. Now, he's preparing to serve out the rest of an 18-month sentence of hard labor.
To me, the most important thing was to spend as much as possible time with my family, with my wife, with my kids, with my parents too. I believe that they will love me as before, as previously, and they will have no problem with that situation that his dad was sent to a jail, that his dad now is criminal. That's our Belarusian reality.
Bancer is one of the 34,000 people in Belarus who've been arrested since last year for protesting Belarus's forever president, Alexander Lukashenko. Lukashenko was the country's first president. Almost 30 years later, he's still in office. Recently, his moves to hang on to that power have gotten more extreme. In May, his government grounded an international flight to arrest a journalist who'd been living in exile. The leader of Belarus's democratic opposition, Sviatlana Tsikhanouskaya, only stepped into that role after her husband, who was running for president, was arrested in May of 2020. Last August, Tsikhanouskaya was forced to leave the country. Her husband is still in prison.
As for me, I'm not leaving now. I'm fighting now. And having husband in jail and my children, and understanding that it's not only me who in such situation, it's thousands of people. So, when journalists ask me, so how are you? I really can't know how to answer, because it's okay to answer, I'm fine, thank you, as it's usually normal people do, but I'm not okay.
Can you describe a bit more what the conditions are like in prison for people like your husband?
You know, I'm not sure that people from democratic countries can't even imagine the situation in Belarusian prisons, especially the attitude to political prisoners, because they are openly said, you are a political prisoner and you will die. I have to say that the best people of Belarus are sitting in jails now, activists, bloggers, IT specialists, professors, doctors, students, all those who had dignity and strength to say their words against regime. And they are, humiliated physically and morally. It's they wish to humiliate people there.
Belarus is a small country compared to its huge neighbor, but it's become a priority for a Washington wary of Russian aggression. The Russian president's ongoing support of Lukashenko is one of the things President Biden brought up when he met with Putin for the first time since taking office.
We agreed to pursue diplomacy related to the Minsk agreement, and I shared our concern about Belarus.
Earlier this month, three members of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee, including Senator Jeanne Shaheen, went to Lithuania to meet with Tsikhanouskaya.
The United States has had a particular interest in what has happened in Belarus in the last few years. Having the opposition leader testify to Congress recently, what is it about Belarus that is so important right now?
Belarus is the place where there is the last fully autocratic dictator in Europe, and I want to see that change.
Why should the U.S. care about what is happening in Belarus? And also, would you care as much if this wasn't an opportunity to kind of whack at Putin?
Well, the reason that it's an issue is because of Russia's continued aggression in Eastern Europe and meddling in the West. We've seen it just recently in terms of the hacking, the cyber hacking that's gone on from entities that are within Russia. So we have to assume that Putin knows who they are. The Colonial Pipeline shutdown is a great example that people can identify with. So there is reason to be concerned about what Russia's next move might be. And it's important for us to make it very clear to our allies that the United States supports them and we will stand strong against Russian aggression.
But almost half of Belarus's economy comes from Russian oil. So pro-democracy Belarusians can't afford to take too strong of a stance.
If you became president, what would your relationship be like with President Putin? How would you handle that?
You know, first of all, I'm not going to participate in new elections. My mandate that people of Belarus gave me is to just prepare these new elections, and other candidates will participate in this. But I'm sure that Belarusians want to be friends with all neighbors. It makes us different from Lukashenko, who fights and quarrels with everyone. We just want to live in a democratic country and build open and transparent trade relationships with all the neighboring countries and other. We are not against Russia. We are against dictatorship.